Thanks for tuning into our podcast. We love having you here, and it's our mission to bring you all the latest and greatest tips, skills, and know-how to make you the best that you can be. We know that you have it in you, and we're going to show you how. Now, let's get started.
Thank you for tuning in today. You are now listening to That Will Nevr Work Podcast with your host, Maurice Chisholm.
Hello, everyone. Thank you very much for tuning in today. You know, I would like to go in a little further. You know, we were talking about resumes for the last couple of episodes, right? And, you know, we had talked about chronological resumes. We've talked about functional resumes, and we've talked about curriculum vitae. I apologize if I'm saying it incorrectly. I don't care how many times someone tells me the right way. For whatever reason, it's not, when I visualize it, unfortunately, I can't get it together. And I understand that will never work. Like, I'm gonna have to figure that part out, right? And some of us have those challenges in just getting things correct, but we're gonna continue to move on. One of the things that we talked about when we talked to, I kind of want to revisit something, being the functional resume. And in a functional resume, we spoke about highlighting your skills and your talents, right? And not necessarily your work experiences, because there could be gaps. There can be a change of industry, if you will. And I want to kind of focus in on that, because when we are ready to make a change, sometimes we don't understand how the skills translate or transfer into another place or situation. So what I'm getting to is, as you continue to mature, as you continue to grow, as you continue to learn, as you continue to view the world in a different light or aspect, as you are having different types of experiences, coming from an entrepreneur perspective, and this goes for both, if you're trying to look for a job and or you're an entrepreneur or a company and you are in the process of changing, sometimes you need to reconsider a rebranding, right, of what you have going on. Ultimately, the idea of what people know you for and what they view you as, there has been a change or a shift in your vision, your mission, your values, and what is it that you're trying to achieve. Now, one of the things that I really would like for people to understand, that in the shifting or pivoting, there can be some challenges. You can get a little discouraged. You can find reasons as to why not to change. You're too nervous. You know, people know me as this, but understanding that, again, as you continue to grow and things start to shift, even your market shifts, right? You know, I have a client, how she stated not too long ago that as the market is shifting, the particular job that she constantly is hiring for, the title itself had changed, right? So now she has to shift with the market or the industry because people are being, I would say, being more respected in some cases and understanding what their real duties are. So you have to kind of shift with the industry. You have to shift your values. You have to shift how you view yourself and or those that are around you, your employees, whatever it is. There is a reshifting in that, a shifting in position, a shifting in philosophy, you know, even in some cases, and this goes to some of my entrepreneurs out there and or business owners. Sometimes you have to reshift because you're unfortunately looking at or something might have happened to you, and you might have to do a PR save, if you will, a public relations save, because something might have happened that people could look at you negatively. Now understand that in a functional resume, because people are highlighting your skills and there are gaps in your work history, sometimes that is the reshifting, if you will, where people are not worried about so much about your gaps, because your gaps could be various things. You quit a job, you had gotten hurt. Unfortunately, some people might have been incarcerated, you know, and there are some work history gaps in there. As I said in a previous episode, as long as we're honest about what's going on, and first being honest with ourselves, and then someone asks us to be honest with them too. But as long as we're honest, we can understand where we are and what's going on. And as we are rebranding ourselves, understanding who we are, understanding what our vision and our mission and our values are, we can now put forth a better product or a better image of ourselves or our organization. You know, also when it comes to a company, you know, just changing your logo, as I heard someone say, that's not a rebrand, that's a reface, right? Just changing a logo does not necessarily mean that people will view you differently, especially if your logo still does not represent, in some cases, who you are, right? If your logo doesn't represent your vision or your mission, you know, and some people get too fancy in certain situations, and their message is either too vague, too busy, too colorful, or there's some type of too something. So let's keep in mind that as we're rebranding ourselves, as we are putting ourselves out there in front of everyone, how do people view you? And is your message being conveyed to those individuals that are out there, that's paying attention to you, who's using your products, that's trying to hire you as you move forward? I encourage you to rethink that, to reevaluate who you are and what you're going on. We talked about resumes for a reason. We're talking about this because of, as you are evaluating this coming, you know, this last quarter of the year, and you're moving into next year, what is it that you need to change? What is it that are your goals and your dreams, your aspirations? Are you going to be able to achieve it if you're still doing the same thing that you were doing 3-4 years ago? We understand that our global situation shifted some things in some positive ways and some negative ways. But I would say in most cases, and is more positive than negative. So now, are you ready to move forward? Are you ready to move forward? Again, are you ready to move forward in a position or a place that challenges you? I hope that each and every one of you out there that are listening to this episode are understanding who you are, right? You know, when you sit down, write down your objective. So when we talk about your mission or your vision, when you're writing down your objective on your resume, does it reflect what you have in mind and what you believe will happen in the future? What are you looking for? What do you project? How do you carry yourself? Are you in that place to make a difference? So let's understand that people do these things to rebrand, and it's not negative. Now, let's understand this too, that as I stated, that sometimes we rebrand because of things are negative, right? Again, if you run into some issues or whatever it is, sometimes that will bring more attention to you. But someone will work with you. You know, if push come to shove, if you're a company, talk to a public relations individual, see what they have to say. Someone that is a social media manager, you know, how do you change the script, if you will, for people to look at you differently. When it comes to an individual, you might have been incarcerated or whatever it is, you know, as long as you are on a positive note, a good footing, I have seen a lot of people been able to change what they felt was negative into a positive. So we're not going to allow anything to hold us back. I encourage you today that you're going to make it happen. Whether you already have your brand, you understand your brand, or you're in the process of this rebranding space, let's understand that just because you change something doesn't always mean it's a rebrand. Is it a facelift?
Loved what you've heard on this week's episode? Well, the answer is simple. It would mean the world to us if you could head over to iTunes and leave us a 5-star review and feedback. Spreading the word really is the best way to grow our podcast and achieve even greater things. Thank you.